Yeah.
You played a while ago in it, but.
Yeah. I'm kind of cool like that.
Hey, you know.
That's nothing compared to four and it's going not. For your fifth, but those players, as they played their way through, had always been on the same team, and then they split into two separate teams here. So now somebody has an opportunity to become a fifth championship victory in the Snapdragon Pro Series. But here we go. Yeah, we got the Queen charge into Dragon Rider for this one. A lot of lightning in the mix.
Oh, he's got six now. So we know that Ghost took five, which was not enough for like Expos. Five is at least enough for an Inferno Tower. But oh no! We got a blimp finding a tornado trap! Wait. There's the Invis. Did he do it early?
Oh, he's
there's
good,
an
he's
earthquake.
Good.
Is he okay? Hold on. Oh!
Yes, he's okay. Ooh. That clutch invisibility is able to get him through away from those storages and get those sneaky goblins to lock on the town hall. Enough space of troops to clear the traps in the area. Pairs it with the quake and the lightning to make sure that he gets that town hall down and all the defenses, that Inferno and Expo that were behind it, is going to make sure the Queen has a very safe approach in the middle base there. She's just going to need some support on the top side. And here comes the King to provide exactly that.
King and the Warden are coming in here to move together. When you can pop that Warden ability and protect all the King's Barbarians, it is insane the value you can get on an attack, as now the rage is down on the Queen to continue her charge, take out this Lava Hound, as this RC is jumping over the wall to take out the enemy RC and the Scatter.
And with the help of the Headhunter and the Freeze protecting his Royal Champion through the high damage right there, but a lot of these defenses are tanked all around. He put the Dragon Riders right over the top of the Warden, and he's able to absorb a whole bunch of Black Binds while he's protecting the heroes and keeps these Dragon Riders alive and moving as they are all working in parallel now.
He's going in with the Royal Champion, taking out the Grand Warden. Remember, the mark that he has to beat is a 95% two-star. That's the victory. If he doesn't get it, that could be trouble for Chasmic. But the Queen is staying up, still has her ability, used all the spells now. There's a lot on this backside, including that multi-target Inferno, just over a minute, 15 seconds left here.
Yeah, but he can mostly just focus on where he can squeeze in his cleanup there and focus onto this Queen, just time this Queen ability to a good spot here right now. She is holding the tension of that scatter shot, but it's still an air defense up ahead. I don't know if he has enough to triple this. It's gonna come down to the wire here, Carbon.
Is the Dragon Riders look the Arca to try to take out that multi. The one Dragon Riders on the Builder Hut is getting hit by the Air Expo. Queen still has her ability, not using it yet. The multi goes down!
Oh, he did get it down before that Expo took out that Dragon Rider. The Queen is still hanging in here. The King is coming back for more.
He still has
a chance. He's gotta get a couple more buildings. What is she attacking?
Opsy ability. He needs a 95. Remember, that's the number. That's the number. He's making his way through into the Wizard Tower with the Warden. He's got an Archer to the left side. Under 30 seconds, but they're high-fiving. They've got the percentage and maybe even the three-star. Lex knows. Gets it done.
That was wild. Carried all the way to the end, and this Queen is still moving. She's going the distance as Chasmac puts up 14. Absolutely wild. And the undefeated stays undefeated for another round.
What a war. Chasmac coming in with 14 stars and delivers to keep the momentum on their side in the upper bracket. But that does not mean Fuzzy Wuzzy is eliminated yet, because they will now play in the lower bracket, which is what happened to Strut yesterday. And they were able to be the whole champion of the EU MENA region. But what a war we had here. Let's welcome back Maxi to the desk. Man, what a performance, and whew, incredible.
Absolutely incredible. I was just astounded by what I was seeing there. And you know, this Lex guy, I mean, I've heard of